For most of the past 2,000 years, Europe has been a battleground between empires, principalities, city-states. It is only after the end of World War II that Project Europe, this ideology of political and economic integration of European countries, was launched. And as a consequence, Europe has known prosperity and peace for the past 70 years. But let's ask ourselves this simple question. What is the default setting for Europe? Europeans, particularly in the South, fell prey to the belief that governments have an obligation to take care of their constituencies like benevolent parents, have infinite resources to do so, and can resolve every problem. They also convinced themselves that they were entitled by birthright to a certain quality of life, and if, to maintain this quality of life, they had to borrow to the hilt, break the bank, and stick the bill to future generations, so be it. The only plausible solution to the complex equation relating the unsustainable cost of the civilization of entitlements to chronic low growth and unfavorable demographics is gradual and irreversible impoverishment. The euro, which was supposed to be the final glue holding Project Europe together, threatens instead to blow it apart. The euro has become a sort of roach motel where countries can get in, but they cannot get out. Rigid labor regulations in Europe have created a two-caste system. The upper caste is made of those enjoying lifetime-long employment contracts with armor-plated full benefits. The rest, the lower caste, is made of people who can only enjoy the crumbs of the labor market. The unions and the left are the guardians of this two-caste system. Compelled to choose between structural reforms and decline, many European countries have chosen decline by default because the only reforms they're willing to stomach are marginal ones. There is a culture of fear now pervading most of Europe. Fear of the future, fear of where the European construct is heading to, fear of globalization, fear of enlargement, fear of Turkey in and of Turkey out, fear of a reunited Germany, fear that Europe has lost it, and fear that there is no coming back to the decades of hope and prosperity. Tend to forget that the main issue in Europe has, since the time of Bismarck, been the German question. The European project was launched after World War II to keep Germany in check. The euro was launched to draw a reunified Germany even closer to Europe. Today's Germany, a colossus among its peers, is profoundly disillusioned with Europe and drifting apart. The main danger in Europe today is a decoupling of Germany that could take us back to square one.